Doomsday preacher Apollo Kibuloy and his co-accused presented to the media this afternoon. Kibuloy, with his face entirely covered, briefly made an appearance during a press conference of the Interior Department and the Philippine National Police. Authorities asserted Kibuloy surrendered because he had no choice since he was already surrounded by police inside the KOJC compound.
Yung pagsuko, formality na lang yun. At the end of the day, whether he likes it or not, the end result will ultimately be the same. So maybe he just chose the path na feeling niya ay mas magaan para sa kanya. And on our part naman, mas gusto naman natin na wala nang masaktan pang additional.
With all of these things na nangyari, I'm sure someone should be guilty of obstruction of justice for harboring, concealing, someone who is wanted by law.
Vice President Sara Duterte insisting she is not a spoiled brat after her controversial confrontation with House lawmakers during a recent budget hearing for her office. Duterte earned the ire of lawmakers for refusing to answer questions on her use of funds when she was Education Secretary. The daughter of former President Rodrigo Duterte says insinuations that she is a spoiled brat is part of a political attack against her and her family.
Alam ng taong bayan na hindi ako bratinela o spoiled brat dahil kilala nila ako simula nung ako ay nasa Davao pa, simula nung ako ay mayor pa, hanggang naging vice president ako. Kilala ako ng taong bayan na hindi ko inaabuso ang aking power and ang aking authority sa lahat ng mga opisina na nahawakan ko.
Justice Secretary Remulla revealing developments in the cases of former Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. and former Prisons Chief Gerald Bantag. Both discharged government officials are wanted for murder. Teves, who is implicated in the killing of the late Negros Oriental Governor Roel De Gamo and 9 others, is detained in Timor-Leste.
Well, the court was filed a rather dilatory tactic. There was a rather dilatory tactic employed by his lawyers in Timor-Leste. But it will be resolved very soon. The end is near. And it's just that today, the Pope, I think, is in Timor-Leste. And they do not want to shake any boots there. They just want to get through with the Pope's visit. After the Pope's visit, I think we will have this resolved very soon. We are not getting a private plane to take him home. We have asked the Air Force to help us, and they have obliged us already.
Meanwhile, Secretary Remulla revealed some politicians are protecting Bantag, who is accused of orchestrating the murder of broadcaster Percy Lapid, an inmate June Villamor.
We have had feelers about his supposed wanting to surrender. But we know we basically know where he is. It's just that he's being protected by his classmates in the PNPA, class of 96, who are now in power. And some politicians are practically protecting him. And we will get to it very soon.
Philippine authorities raised to 20 the death toll from the onslaught of Typhoon Yagi in the country. The Disaster Management Agency says most of the fatalities came from the southern Tagalog region. Some 26 others remain missing. The storm, locally known as Enteng, displaced 2.8 million people, majority coming from Bicol and Central Luzon. The NDRRMC says it left nearly 700 million pesos in damage to infrastructure, while losses in agriculture amounted to 660 million. Yagi has since been dubbed as Asia's most powerful storm this year. The Philippine Transportation Department in favor of the supposed reassignment of terminals at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. That's according to San Miguel Corporation President Ramon Ang. He told an aviation forum, Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista also believes the reassignment of airlines will decongest NAIA terminals. San Miguel heads the consortium that is in charge of the rehabilitation of Metro Manila's main gateway. Aside from the reassignment, the consortium also aims to increase the takeoff and landing movements to 48 per hour from the current 30.